Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on the GATE question paper in Mechanical Engineering. And this is lecture number 20 on internal combustion engine. We are going to solve few questions from the GATE question paper, and we discuss the numerical solution in detail. And these are all the books I have published: Design of Transmission System, Turbo Machines, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. And also I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subjects mentioned here, and the video lectures on the GATE question paper solution is also uploaded in the YouTube channel. So today the students, they are using the YouTube video more for their learning. They can use the video at their convenient time for their better learning, and I request you to subscribe the channel, use the videos, and you pass in your GATE examination. I wish you all the best. So it is absolutely free of cost. So the first question is from question 2000 question paper. A diesel engine develops a brake power of 4.5 kilowatts. Its indicated thermal efficiency is 30% and the mechanical efficiency is 85%. Take the calorific value of the fuel as 40,000 kilojoules per kilogram and calculate the fuel consumption kilograms per hour and the indicated specific fuel consumption. So the given data, brake power equal to 4.5 kilowatt, indicated thermal efficiency is 0.3, mechanical efficiency is 0.85, calorific value is 40,000 kilojoules per kilogram. And the indicated power, IP equal to BP divided by mechanical efficiency. So 4.5 divided by 0.85 equal to 5.29 kilowatts. And the fuel consumption kilograms per hour. So fuel consumption MF equal to IP divided by indicated thermal efficiency into calorific value. So 5.29 divided by 0.3 into 40,000 equal to 4.41 into 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second, which is 1.587 kilograms per hour. And the indicated specific fuel consumption, ISFC equal to MF divided by IP equal to 1.587 divided by 5.29 equal to 0.3 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So these are all the answers to the problem. Mass of the fuel equal to 1.587 kilograms per hour, and the indicated specific fuel consumption is 0.3 kilograms per kilowatt hour. The next question is from 2001 question paper. A mechanic has an engine from a 1970 model car which works on auto cycle. So it is a petrol engine. The engine displaces 1.8 liters, has a compression ratio of 10.2:1 and has 6 cylinders. The pistons in the original engine are 120 millimeter in diameter. The mechanic bores the cylinder and replaces the piston with a new piston that are 2 mm larger in diameter than the originals. So, one, keeping all the other factors same, what will be the percentage change in the power output? And the second question, by what percentage will the engine efficiency change? And the given data, swept volume is 1.8 liters, R compression ratio is 10.2, auto cycle, it is auto cycle petrol engine, number of cylinder K equal to 6, diameter equal to 0.12 millimeter, so 12 meter, and the revised diameter. So, after boring, revised diameter is 0.122 meter. So, 2 millimeter larger. So, volume per cylinder. So, it is 1.8 liters for 6 cylinder engine. Volume per cylinder is 1.8 divided by 6 equal to 0.3 liters. And the compression ratio equal to Vs plus Vc divided by Vc. So, that equal to Vs by Vc plus 1. So, R equal to 10.2. So, the compression ratio equal to 10.2 equal to 0.3 divided by Vc plus 1. So, Vc compression ratio, clearance volume equal to 0.0326 liters. Now the brake power produced. So for the first engine, brake power equal to brake mean effective pressure pi by 4 d square L n k. So here diameter is the only parameter varied. All the other parameters are constant. So I write the equation as C into d square. So the second brake power BP1, second engine with the rebored engine. So BP1 equal to again PA, brake mean effective pressure pi by 4 d square L n k. So now this is C into D1 square. So diameter is replaced by D1 square. Now the percentage increase in the power. So BP minus BP1 minus BP divided by BP into 100 equal to C D1 square minus C D square divided by C D square. So C is getting cancelled into 100. So D1 square minus D square divided by D square. So 0.122 square minus 0.12 square divided by 0.12 square into 100 equal to 3.361%. So the increase in the power is 3.361%. And increase in the compression ratio. So because of the reboring, there is change in the compression ratio. We have original stroke volume or the stroke volume is 0.3 liters. So pi by 4 d square into L equal to 0.3 into 10 power minus 3 liter into meter cube. So the stroke length equal to, we calculate 0.3 into 10 power minus 3 into 4 divided by pi into 0.12 square equal to 0.0265 meter. For the new reboard engine, the swept volume VS1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square into L. So pi by 4 into 0.122 square into 0.0265. So calculating 0.3096 liters. So new compression ratio equal to VS1 plus VC divided by VC. So there is no change in the clearance volume. So 0.3096 plus 0.0326 divided by 0.0326 equal to 10.5. So new compression ratio is 10.5. The original compression ratio 10.2. Now the percentage increase in efficiency. Efficiency for the original engine 1 minus 1 by r to the power gamma minus 1. So 1 minus 1 by 10.2 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.605. And the eta for the revised engine, reboard engine, 1 minus 1 by r1 to the power gamma minus 1. So 1 minus 1 by 10.5 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.6095. Now the percentage of increase in efficiency, eta 1 minus eta divided by eta into 100 equal to 0.6095 minus 0.605 divided by 0.605 equal to 0.744%. That is the increase in the efficiency of the engine. The next question paper from 2002 question paper, the valence line measures for a measured for a 4-stroke 4-cylinder is expressed as FC equal to 0.15 plus 0.03 BP, where FC is the rate of fuel consumption in grams per second and BP is the brake power in kilowatt. The bore of each cylinder is 75 mm and the stroke is 90 mm and the speed of the engine is 3000 rpm. Calculate the indicated power, mechanical efficiency and the indicated mean effective pressure when the engine is developing a brake power of 20 kilowatt. So we write down the given data, diameter equal to 0.75 millimeter, 0.075 meter, length equal to 90 millimeter, 0.09 meter, speed equal to 3000 rpm, number of cylinder equal to 4, and it is a 4-stroke cycle engine, and the brake power equal to 20 kilowatts. And we are given valence line, FC equal to 0.15 plus 0.03 into brake power. When FC, fuel consumption, is 0, the brake power is equal to friction power. So, think of the construction of the valence line. So, the extension of the valence line. So, we take a brake power in the x-axis, fuel consumption in the y-axis. We draw the brake power versus fuel consumption and we extend the line to the negative x-axis. The line, the point at which the line meets, it is called as negative brake power, which is friction power. So, the friction power FP equal to 0.15 divided by 0.03 equal to 5 kilowatts. Now, the indicated power equal to IP equal to BP plus FP equal to 20 plus 5 equal to 25 kilowatts. Now, we calculate the mechanical efficiency. Mechanical efficiency equal to BP by IP into 100. So, 20 divided by 25 into 100 equal to 80%. And we calculate the indicated mean effective pressure. So, IP is given. So IP is given as PIMALNK. So the small n equal to capital N divided by 2 for 4 stroke cycle engine. So PIMALN divided by 2 into 60 into K. So the indicator mean effective pressure equal to IP into 2 into 60 divided by area equal to pi by 4 d square L into N into K. So substitute the numerical value is 25 into 2 into 60 divided by pi by 4 into 0.075 square into 0.09 into 3000 into 4 equal to 629 kilopascal. So the indicator mean effective pressure equal to 629 kilopascal. The next question is from 2004 question paper. So during a most test on a 4-stroke engine, the following measurements of brake power were taken at constant speed. When all the cylinders are firing, the brake power equal to 3037 kilowatts. When number 1 cylinder is not firing, brake power equal to 2102 kilowatts. When number 2 cylinder is not firing, brake power equal to 2102 kilowatts. When number 3 cylinder is not firing, brake power equal to 2100 kilowatts. And when number 4 cylinder is not firing, brake power equal to 2098 kilowatt. The mechanical efficiency of the engine, there are 4 options given: 91.53, 85.07, 81.07, 61.22. The answer is 81.07. So we will see how in the next slide. So we are given brake power equal to, total brake power equal to 3037 kilowatts. BP1, when the first cylinder is not working, 2102 kilowatts. BP2, when the second cylinder is not working, 2102 kilowatts. BP3, when the third cylinder is not working, 2100 kilowatts. And BP4, when the fourth cylinder is not working, 2098 kilowatts. So we calculate the indicated power. So IP1 equal to BP minus BP1 equal to 3037 minus 2102 equal to 935 kilowatts. IP2 equal to BP minus BP2 equal to 3037 minus 2102 equal to 935 kilowatts. IP3 equal to BP minus BP3 equal to 3037 minus 2100 equal to 937 kilowatts. And IP4 equal to BP minus BP4 equal to 3037 minus 2098 equal to 939 kilowatts. So the total indicator power equal to IP1 plus IP2 plus IP3 plus IP4. So you read this as IP2 plus IP3 plus IP4 equal to 935 plus 935 plus 937 plus 939 equal to 3746 kilowatts. And the mechanical efficiency equal to brake power divided by the indicator power into 100 equal to 3037 divided by 3746 into 100 equal to 81.07%. So the next question is from 1987 question paper. In a test on 4-cylinder spark ignition engine, the following power and the fuel consumption measurements were made. With all the cylinders firing, 30 kilowatts, brake power equal to 30 kilowatts. When the cylinder 1 is not firing, 20.75 kilowatts. When the cylinder 2 is not firing, 20.5 kilowatts. When the cylinder 3 is not firing, 20.5 kilowatts. When the cylinder 4 is not firing, 20.75 kilowatts. The time taken to consume 250 ml of fuel is 85 seconds. The specific gravity of the fuel is 0.85. Calorific value of the fuel is 40 megajoules per kilogram. Determine mechanical efficiency, brake thermal efficiency of the engine. And we are given the given data, BP equal to 30 kilowatts, BP1 equal to 20.75 kilowatts, BP2 equal to 20.5 kilowatts, BP3 equal to 20.5 kilowatts, BP4 equal to 20.75 kilowatts. Mass of the fuel equal to 250 milliliter in 85 seconds. Specific gravity equal to 0.85. So the density of the fuel equal to 850 kilograms per meter cube. So specific gravity into 1000, density of water, that gives the density of the fuel 850 kilograms per meter cube, and calorific value equal to 40 megajoules per kilogram. Now we calculate the indicated power of the individual cylinders of the multi-cylinder engine. So IP1 equal to BP minus BP1 equal to 30 minus 20.75 equal to 9.25 kilowatts. IP2 equal to BP minus BP2 equal to 30 minus 20.5 equal to 9.5 kilowatts. IP3 equal to BP minus BP3 equal to 30 minus 20.5 equal to 9.5 kilowatts. And IP4 equal to BP minus BP4 minus 30 minus 20.5 20.75 equal to 9.25 kilowatts. So the total brake indicator power equal to IP1 plus IP2 plus IP3 plus IP4 equal to 9.25 plus 9.5 plus 9.5 plus 9.25 equal to 37.5 kilowatts. Then the mechanical efficiency of the engine. So eta m equal to BP by IP into 100. So 37.5 into 100 equal to 80%. And the mass of the fuel consumed. So we are given 250 milliliter. So 250 milliliter equal to 250 into 10 power minus 3. So into 10 power minus 3. So liter to meter cube. Milliliter to meter. Liter 10 power minus 3. And this is 10 power minus 3 to convert liter into meter cube into 850 density divided by 85 equal to 2.5 into 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second. And the brake thermal efficiency equal to BP by MF into CV. Mass of the fuel into calorific value equal to 30 divided by 2.5 into 10 power minus 3 into 40,000 into 100 equal to 30%. That is the brake thermal efficiency of the engine. The next question is from 1991 question paper. A 6-cylinder 4-stroke diesel engine having bore 18 cm and the stroke 32 cm develops a torque of 390 Nm. And the indicator mean effective pressure is 700 kPa at 280 rpm. The following observations were made during the experiment. Fuel consumption 3 kg per hour, cooling water flow 4 kg per minute, increase in cooling water temperature 35 degree Celsius, air fuel ratio 22, room temperature 20 degree Celsius, the barometer reading 1 bar. If the calorific value of the fuel is 42 megajoules per kilogram, find the indicated horsepower, indicated thermal efficiency, mechanical efficiency, volumetric efficiency and heat loss in cooling water. So we write down the given data. So diameter equal to 0.18 meter, stroke length equal to 0.32 meter, the torque produces 390 Newton meter, indicated mean effective pressure is 700 kilopascal, speed equal to 280 rpm, mass of the fuel equal to 3 kilograms per hour, mass of the cooling water is 4 kilograms per minute, the rise in temperature of the cooling water delta TW equal to 35 degrees Celsius, the ambient temperature is 20 degrees Celsius, atmospheric pressure is 1 bar, calorific value is 42 megajoules per kilogram and air fuel ratio is 22. Now we calculate the mass of the air equal to mass of MA equal to air fuel ratio into mass of the fuel, which is 22 into 3 equal to 66 kilograms per hour. And we calculate the indicated power IP equal to PIM ALNK, which is equal to PIM AL small n equal to capital N divided by 2 for 4-stroke cycle engine into 60 into K is the number of cylinders. So substitute the numerical values. 700 into pi by 4 into 0.18 square into 0.32 into 280 divided by 2 into 60 into 1 equal to 13.3 kilowatts. The indicator power equal to 13.3 kilowatts. Brake power equal to 2 pi nt by 60. So 2 pi n torque, n speed equal to 280 rpm, torque equal to 390 divided by 60 equal to 11.43 kilowatts. And the mechanical efficiency equal to BP by IP into 100, which is 11.43 divided by 13.3 into 100 equal to 85.9%. And the indicated thermal efficiency, eta I indicated thermal efficiency, IP by MF into CV, which is 13.3 divided by 3 divided by 3600 into 42,000 into 100 equal to 38%. And density of the air from the in the ambient conditions, rho A equal to PA by R into TA from the perfect gas equation. So, pressure is 1 bar, which is 100 kilopascal divided by R equal to 0.287. Temperature is given as 20 degree Celsius, which is 293 Kelvin. So, the density of the air equal to 1.189 kilograms per meter cube. And theoretical mass of the air. So, we calculate from the dimensions of the cylinder. Mass of the air, theoretical air equal to rho A into pi by 4 d square L into n divided by 2 into 60 for the 4-stroke cycle engine. So 1.189 into pi by 4 into 0.18 square into 0.32 into 280 divided by 2 into 60 equal to 0.0226 kilograms per second or 81.36 kilograms per hour. Now we calculate the volumetric efficiency. So volumetric efficiency equal to actual mass of the air divided by theoretical mass of the air into 100. So 66 divided by 81.36 into 100 equal to 81.12%. We calculate the heat loss to the cooling water, Qw equal to Mw Cpw into delta Tw. So 4 divided by 60 into 4.187, Cpw equal to 4.187, delta Tw equal to 35, that is equal to 9.77 kilojoules per second. So we stop here. So thank you for watching. So if you have any comments, you post the comments on the comments box of the YouTube video. So you subscribe the channel so that you will get the intimation regarding the updated videos, and you can contact me through mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. So thank you for watching once again. I will meet you in the next video lecture with additional questions from the GATE question paper. Thank you.